least 15 salmon sharks from Monterey Bay have mysteriously washed up dead on Santa Cruz County beaches in the past month, including this one. Another startling sighting on shore these days, the great white shark. Three of them have washed up in the last year. Last month, this juvenile was found on an Aptos beach. Marine life experts said the shark weighed 500 pounds. The Department of Fish and Wildlife has now opened a criminal investigation into the shark's death, which suggests possible foul play.
Regardless of any discussion of the cause, we've got three dead white sharks. We haven't had that.
The Pelagic Shark Research Foundation, a conservation group based in Santa Cruz, responds to stranded sharks on Bay Area shores and assists the state in sending them to labs for testing. It is seeing more unusual die-offs this year.
One's a clear indication of a pathogen infection that caused the stranding. A second shark in August of last year was apparently struck by a boat. It was a mortal, propeller strike to the head.
Executive Director Sean Van Someren believes people may pose more of a threat to the great whites than the predators pose to us.
That includes everything from runoff to plastics, pollutions, chemical, toxic spills.
Van Someren says debris and trash in Bay Area storm drains that gets washed into the bay may be killing the creatures.
It's 11 o'clock. Going the same direction, I'm gonna poke alongside, no tag.
But at the same time sharks are dying, young great whites appear to be thriving in Monterey Bay.
Watch for fins. You see the dorsal fin and the tip of the tail oftentimes.
This is the first time Van Someren has taken a media crew along with him on his latest project, identifying individual sharks using GoPro video near Capitola and Aptos. On previous trips, he's also tagged the sharks and taken biopsies. He notes the sex, age, and any peculiar marks.
We've been on this shark survey for about 2 hours, and this is our third shark that we're seeing. Take a good look right there. We're pretty close to shore, less than 1,000 feet, and I'm told this shark is less than a year old.
The area's been famous for large sharks for a very long time. What's unusual is the presence and gathering of younger sharks, which are typically born down off, Baja, Southern California.
So why has Monterey Bay become a new home for so many young great whites? Van Someren says they were first spotted in the bay in 2015. And his studies have found that they've returned every spring and summer since.
I think it's a combination of the current influences as well as the gathering of food sources.
A healthy Monterey Bay may be attracting the young great whites, but there is so much more we don't know about the feared fish.
There's not a lot known about the juveniles in particular. White sharks have never been documented mating or pupping.
The Pelagic Shark Research Foundation hopes to better understand their behavior and will continue to fish for more information, both on and offshore. In Capitola, Betty Yu, KPIX 5.